Hi, Dr. Minkoff, LifeWorks Wellness Center. I want to talk to you about gut problems. So the term is dysbiosis. Biosis is our living things. Dysbiosis are abnormal living things in places where they shouldn't be. So the most common thing of dysbiosis is gut dysbiosis. So it's things growing in your intestine that shouldn't be growing there. And they're causing problems. Now, our intestines, our small intestine is probably 25 feet long. Our large intestine is probably 8 feet long. The large intestine is full of bacteria. In fact, there are more bacteria living in your large intestine than there are all the cells of your body. Now that's because these bacteria are very small compared to our human cells. And so a lot of them can fit in a compressed space. The food that we eat is not sterile. You're not boiling everything that you eat. And you don't wash off your fingernails with alcohol every time that you want to nip off a little piece of skin that's extra there. And so we are exposed to bacteria all day long, every day. And those bacteria come in through our stomach. And if we have a healthy stomach, it produces real high-level hydrochloric acid. It kills all those guys that are coming down. So if you went to the sushi bar and there's some parasites in that sushi, which is very common, by the time they get to your stomach, if you have good stomach acid, they're killed. And so the stuff that comes after that into your small intestine isn't infected or doesn't contain infectious material. And then the food is extracted and you have a bowel movement and there's bacteria in the colon, which pull out the water, add some things, and you're all good. Probably at least 50% of people don't have stomach acid because either their stomach is sick and it's not producing it, or they take some kind of drug like Nexium or Tagamet or, you know, these Pepcid. These drugs block stomach acid. Now, if you have an acute bleeding ulcer, you need these drugs for a couple of weeks. If you don't, you're crazy if you're taking them. And probably your doctor prescribed them. But in the physician's desk reference, it says these drugs should not be taken for more than 2 or 3 weeks, because they block stomach acid and they block absorption of magnesium and potassium and critical minerals. And they lead to stomach cancer and. Okay? They're toxic. They're terrible. Okay? And many people, they're now over the counter and anybody can buy them. And the prescription ones, there's like 25 million prescriptions a month of people who are prescribed these drugs. Okay? It's really the wrong answer. They need to change their diet, change their food, take supplements to fix their stomach. But on those drugs, whatever you're coming into your mouth is coming into your intestine. And sometimes we get overgrowth of bacteria in the small intestine. And that's called SIBO, S-I-B-O, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. You're not supposed to have bacteria in your small intestine. But if you have them there, they're gonna ferment food, produce bloating, gas, heartburn, discomfort, spasm, bad breath. And then if those bacteria also go down into your colon and they're bad type bacteria, so there's two kinds of bacteria. Good bacteria help us. They help with metabolism. They help make stuff that we need. Bad bacteria cause inflammation and infection in the wall of the gut. They cause leaky gut. They allow things to come into our body that shouldn't be there. 100% of everyone that walks in our clinic has dysbiosis. I never don't find it in someone who's got a health complaint. If you're gluten intolerant and you eat gluten, you're gonna have dysbiosis. If you're dairy intolerant and you eat dairy, you're gonna have dysbiosis. Virtually all prescription medications cause leakage in the intestinal membrane. You're gonna have leakage and you're gonna have dysbiosis. So getting a healthy gut is the key to health. Nobody with a bad gut is healthy. The gut, as you know, is connected with the brain. The biggest nerve network in the body connects the brain to the gut. Vagus nerve network. And when the gut's not happy, the brain's not happy. Many of the neurotransmitters, the chemicals in the brain that are needed to have normal mood and normal attitude, are made in the gut. And they're made by the gut cells, and the vagus nerve pulls them up and puts them in the brain. And so if you're on Prozac or one of these drugs because you have low serotonin, guess what? Serotonin is made in the gut. That's where it comes from. And so if you don't have good gut cells, you're not going to have serotonin. Then you're going to feel depressed. And then it's worse than that because Prozac kills good bacteria. It kills good bacteria. So not only do you wreck your own stuff, but then you don't make the stuff that you need to be decent, and you get into this catch-22 where, okay, you want health, you want vitality, you want longevity. That is not the way that you're going to get it. So attention to gut health is really important. It starts with food. What we find for most people is a six-week trial of a paleo-type diet. So meat, fish, eggs, fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. No grains, no dairy, no nightshade vegetables. Try it for 6 weeks. Organic as you can. Don't buy stuff that's in a package. Many, many people, if they have dysbiosis, so they might have constipation or watery stools or stomach cramps or mood alterations or skin rashes, it goes away because it's food related. If you're on a blocker, they're called H2 blocker, they block stomach acid, well, those have to be weaned off, and you can't just stop those, and you need help with it. But we start giving people stomach acid, because stomach acid makes heartburn go away in most people. And then you might need good bacteria. You might need something to kill the bad bacteria. But this is a solvable problem. It is very, very, very common. Like I said, almost everybody that comes in here has this. And within 6 to 12 weeks, it's fixed. And they have normal bowel movements, and their bloat is gone. Their stomach is flat, and if it's affecting their mood, and their it's better. And the other thing, we did an earlier video on osteoarthritis. Their joints stop hurting. Their fingers start to feel good. Their joint flexibility gets better. Their muscle pain starts going away because these are all toxins that are generated from the gut. So dysbiosis is number one important thing. It is diagnosable. It is treatable. And it can make a huge difference in anyone of any age. And once that's solved, the person just feels like a new person. Okay? That's gut dysbiosis. Hope this helps.